The Human Rights and Peace Center yesterday engaged members of parliament and urged them to step their oversight mandate in order to enhance transparency and accountability in government.
There is also the Nabanja Fund, if you remember, which instead of the food relief which was given in the first wave, this time round certain individuals were allocated 100,000. That is $28.
They expressed concerns that over 1.7 trillion shillings of the COVID-19 funds have not been accounted for, yet Parliament is seemingly doing less to demand for accountabilities of these funds.
We've also seen certain individuals and companies that have benefited, from COVID resources, which has really remained unchecked and undocumented.
Professor Joe Oloka Onyango from the School of Law, Makerere, reminded MPs of their constitutional powers to oversee the executive, which has not been exploited to push for accountability.
Of course, the Constitution is supreme. But under the Constitution, Parliament is next. And under that is the executive. Please let us not change the order of things, where some people think that the executive is superior to Parliament. No, Parliament under the Constitution is first.
Because I have seen that around the country, every technocrat, every player, every individual, every person is concerned about their stomach. And when they want to get something big, they run to Parliament. So if Parliament can be able to say, hold a little, wait, before we give you this, debate is here.
Professor Onyango challenged Parliament on the failure to compel Henry Kapineti of Uganda Vinch Coffee Company to appear before the Committee of Trade and Tourism, where she was summoned recently. Yet the Constitution gives parliamentary committee powers of the High Court to summon witnesses.
An act or omission which obstructs or impedes Parliament in the performance of its functions, or which obstructs or impedes a member in the discharge of his or her duties, or affronts the dignity of Parliament, or which tends either directly or indirectly to produce such a result, shall be contempt of Parliament.
The former leader of opposition, Win Kiza, tasked MPs to redeem themselves and reclaim their constitutional powers in order to hold government accountable. She emphasized the need for MPs to follow up on implementation of their resolutions.
Parliament has put in place the Auditor General to ease the work that we do, to ensure that accountability becomes possible so that you can be able to do your oversight role. Where do you carry out your oversight role? You do it in your constituencies to follow up the money, the projects of government that are in your constituencies. How often do you follow them to see whether the right things are the ones that are being done?
As a member of Parliament, we want to be straightforward and tell the people who has embezzled our money, please, what you have done is not okay.
This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi.